Today I present a topic regarding bed clearing and spacing. Introduction. Bed clearing is done to remove fecal matter, dead worms, diseased worms and leaf remnants which would promote fungal growth. It is done after every molt for engaged silkworms and every day for the mature silkworms. Bed cleaning is best done before feeding the silkworm. Silkworms do not consume all the mulberry leaves that are supplied to them, and invariably part of the feed is left behind the rearing bed. At the same time, the larvae also defecate and their feces remain on the rearing bed. If the residual mulberry leaves and the fecal matter are left on the rearing bed for a long time, both start decomposing and fermentation, thereby quickly increasing the dampness of the bed. This adversely affects the larval physiology. Therefore, it is essential to periodically remove the waste materials from the bed and keep it clean. This process is known as bed cleaning. The bed cleaning is normally carried out 3 times daily. It is done when the larvae have freshly molted or larvae enter to the molting phase, and also in between at a suitable time. The bed is cleaned 2 or 3 times at the time of molting after supplying the mulberry leaves to each larval instar. The bed cleaning is carried out when the larvae are actively feeding. The bed cleaning is also done when the larvae are entered to the molting phase, that is, they stop feeding and become quiescent. During bed cleaning, the diseased larvae are mixed with silkworm excreta. When there are too many larvae, the larval excreta as well as the diseased larvae should be handled with care. In other words, all efforts should be made to save the healthy larvae from infected larvae with pathogen. Objectives. As soon as the silkworm larvae grown up, the unconsumed leaves and litter increases in the rearing bed, which ultimately cause changing atmosphere and favoring multiplication of pathogenic organism. Hence, timely bed cleaning is essential to keep the silkworms healthy. Frequent cleaning is better, but it involves more labor and ultimately silkworm rearing is uneconomical. Therefore, it is necessary to prepare stage-wise cleaning schedule. The main objectives of bed cleaning is to remove fecal matter, dead worms and leaf remnants which would promote fungal growth, and to maintain the hygienic condition during silkworm rearing. Importance of bed cleaning. As soon as the larvae grown up, the unconsumed leaves and litter increases the rearing bed, which ultimately causes changing atmosphere and favoring multiplication of pathogenic organism. Hence, timely bed cleaning is essential to keep the silkworms healthy. Frequent cleaning is better, but it involves more labor and ultimately silkworm rearing is uneconomical. Therefore, it is necessary to prepare a stage-wise cleaning schedule. Only one bed cleaning is sufficient during first instar silkworm, otherwise the loss of worms will be more. In the second stage, 2 times bed cleaning is required after first molt and before second molt. It should be done after 1 or 2 feedings. 3 times bed cleaning is required to the 3rd and 4th instars. First after second molt, second in the middle, and 3rd before going to the 3rd molt, similarly in between 3rd and 4th instar. But in 5th instar, the leaf consumption is increases comparatively than the other instars. Ultimately, the bed becomes thick and damp soon. Therefore, it is necessary for daily bed cleaning is in this stage, preferably in the morning after 1 or 2 feedings. The method of bed cleaning is practiced in sericulture is simple and easy. Prior to bed cleaning, feeding should be given with the fresh leaves. Then the worms along with the fresh leaves should be transferred to a new rearing tray carefully. Maximum care should be taken not to harm the worms during handling. This method of bed cleaning is therefore to be accomplished through experience. Silkworms after molting leave the excuvia. All the leaves fed to the silkworm may not be consumed. Dried leaves, injected leaves in the rearing bed, silkworms excreta, dead worms, diseased worms, all will increase the humidity, fermentation, temperature in the rearing bed. If proper bed clearing is not done in time, it leads to the various complications wise the health of the larvae, disinterest of the larvae to feed due to the unhygienic condition, ultimately silkworm becomes weak. To clean the rearing bed, spread nylon net over the silkworms and spread fresh leaves on the top of the nylon net. Silkworms will crawl onto nylon net to feed fresh mulberry leaves on the net. Transfer the worms using the net to another clean bed or tray. Remove any remaining worms, then discard the waste into a composite pile. Spread the silkworms well and then feed them. Bed cleaning in silkworm rearing tray is done by various methods like using a paddy husk, straw and bed cleaning net. During first instar, bed cleaning should be done once during pre-molting, during second instar twice, once after molt and before next molt. During third instar thrice, that is after molt, before next molt and once in the middle. During the fourth and fifth stage, once in a day in case of self-rearing. However, in case of low-rearing or shoot-rearing, once in each instar. Bed cleaning is carried out with the help of a brush or a net. When a net is used, it is spread over the rearing bed and then the mulberry leaves are supplied. After some time, the silkworms gradually rise up on the net in search of fresh mulberry leaves. Before the next feeding, the larvae along with the net are transferred to the another rearing tray. The net for the young larvae is made up of soft cotton or even jute or synthetic fiber. Nets are made up of metal wires or used for the grown-up larvae. The mesh of the net varies with the larval stages. A brush or broom is used for bed cleaning only when there are no larvae on the bed. When fresh mulberry leaves are supplied, the silkworms gradually approach them and can be picked up by hand and transferred to another tray. Bed cleaning is done once during second day of fifth instar following rope or net method. In rope method, spread 2 meter length of rope at a parallel row, leaving 0.5 meter on the other side. After 2 to 3 feedings, ends of the ropes are pulled to the center to make into a bundle. In net cleaning method, spread 1.5 cm size net across the bed. After 2 or 3 feedings, the nets are lifted and the whole bed is cleaned and disinfected. Transfer the net to new shelf. Spread the net over the shoots, larvae will migrate to lower layer. Advantages: labor saving up to 70% when compared to hour-to-hour basis with leaf feeding method. Leaf saving up to 15-20%, hence leaf cocoon ratio is less by 2-3 kg and extra cocoon production. Better cocoon characters and effective rate of rearing. Better preservation of leaf quality both during storing and on the bed. More organic matter production, 18 tons per hectare per year. Better hygienic condition can be maintained. Handling of silkworms minimized, hence contamination and spreading of diseases are reduced. Bed cleaning only once after a fifth molt. Silkworms and leaves are kept away from the litter, hence chances of secondary contaminations are minimized. Labor dependent risk is reduced. Disadvantages: required rearing room floor area is more. Bed refusals will not be available as a cattle feed. Planting materials will not be available. Bed cleaning for chalky rearing. Silkworms are fed with large quantity of mulberry leaves than their eating capacity. Thus, unconsumed leaves which are unfit for food remain in the trays at the end of each feeding. Besides this, excreta of silkworm forms a thick bed. Out of the total weight of the leaf taken as a food, 3/5 is excreted and only 2/5 is being assimilated by the silkworm. The peeling of litter makes the bed moist. This releases process of fermentation, liberating injurious gases and also favors multiplication of pathogens. All these above factors are harmful to the silkworms. Therefore, removal of old mulberry leaves, fecal matter of silkworms, exuvia, dead or unhealthy silkworm, etc. from the rearing bed is called bed cleaning. Frequency of bed cleaning. Cleaning involves labor and frequent cleaning is not advisable as it cuts the economics of rearing. While bed cleaning, loss of silkworm is inevitable capacity in chalk rearing. The frequencies of bed cleaning for a young silkworm are as follows. First instar once, second instar twice, that is once just after the first molt and again before going to the second molt. Third instar thrice, that is once after molt, once in the middle of third instar and once just before going to the fourth molt. Method of bed cleaning. For bed cleaning, paddy husk, net, cut straw methods are used. There are three methods of bed cleaning. Cleaning with paddy husk, cleaning with nylon net, cleaning with paddy husk and nylon net. Cleaning with paddy husk. In this method, charred husk or paddy husk is sprinkled uniformly over the bed of silkworm. This sprinkling of paddy husk is carried just prior to first feeding early in the morning. The worms crawl through the husk layer to reach the mulberry leaves. During the second feeding, the bed is ready for cleaning. All the silkworms are collected together by a brush and transferred into the fresh tray. The natural paddy husk is too big and too thick for first two ages. Thereby, the worms cannot come up. For these ages, husk should be broken into small pieces before it is used. Care should be taken to avoid dust of husk as it spoils the leaves of it to the silkworm. Formalized charred husk helps to avoid attack of muscardine diseases. Cleaning with net. In this process, a net with mesh suited to the size of the silkworms are used. During the process of cleaning, the net is spread over the bed just prior to the first feeding early in the morning. Then it is cleaned after second feeding. It is a very simple method and requires little labor. However, it is not convenient for the purpose of spacing. The mesh sizes of the different cleaning nets are: first and second instar is 2 mm square, third instar is 10 mm square. Combined husk and net method. In this process of bed cleaning, both husk and net are used. First, a thin layer of paddy husk is sprinkled over the bed and a suitable net is spread. Then after two feedings, the worms are transferred along with the net into another tray. This process is more expensive and not suitable for spacing. Silkworm larvae feed on mulberry leaves, derive nourishment from them and grow. As they grow, they need a larger area for rearing. In other words, while preparing the rearing bed, proper spacing is necessary for the growing larvae. Unless proper provision for spacing is made to population density of the larvae, in the rearing bed becomes very high and this results in congestion. In such an event, the larvae are not able to consume enough quality of mulberry leaves and suffering from malnutrition, which adversely affects the physiology of silkworm. The congested rearing of larvae also may lead to induction of viral diseases in them. At the same time, when the viral and other diseases break out, even the healthy larvae may become infected with the pathogens and the chances of their infection invariably increases. As the larvae grow, it is therefore necessary to appropriately enlarge and space out the rearing bed. Spacing needs to be carefully planned right from the rearing of the first instar to the fifth instar larvae. As the larval growth is gradual, rearing can be initially done in a single tray on the rearing bed. Later, as larvae grow, it becomes impossible to accommodate them all in one tray and they need to be spread out into many trays. In other words, the rearing started in a single tray need to be carried out in two or more trays by dividing the larvae into groups. While spacing can be planned as per the practical requirements during rearing, the standard practice is to space out daily during the first instar at the time of the fourth or fifth feeding from the second instar onwards, but twice during the peak feeding period. As already mentioned, with too many larvae per unit area of the rearing bed, it gives rise to what is popularly known as crowded rearing. The opposite of this condition is lean rearing. When the crowding of larvae is too much, there is a shortage of feed resulting in malnutrition. Also, the silkworm diseases occur frequently and a large number of larvae become diseased. Subsequently, the quality of cocoon deteriorates, the cocoon yield becomes low and the whole cocoons are weak. The damage is particularly extensive when both the temperature and humidity are high. On the other hand, if the rearing is lean, it is uneconomical in terms of the labor involved in the collecting mulberry leaves, maintenance of the rearing room, and the number of rearing implements are used. Another type of problem occurs during the rearing of engaged larvae as large number of them are lost along with the leftover mulberry leaves when they are discarded. The area of the rearing bed depends upon the many conditions. For example, the size of the larvae, which is not always the same in different strains of the silkworm. Moreover, there is a difference in size between the spring and summer autumn larvae. As silkworms increase in size, transfer some larvae to another bed or tray to avoid overcrowding. Overcrowding leads to underfeeding, creating a microclimate for disease spread and could also lead to suffocation. The maintenance of optimum number of worms per unit area according to their size or stages of the worm during rearing is called spacing of silkworms. Proper spacing and good aeration keeps the worms healthier. Overcrowding of the silkworms in a rearing tray leads to the competition for the food and space and ultimately undernourishment and unhealthy growth of the larvae, often result in crop loss. Optimum spacing is therefore to be accomplished through experience. Spacing of the worms should be made combining with cleaning. 2 times rearing space is sufficient from the first instar to the third instar. In fourth instar, it may be necessary to increase the space by 2 or 3 times and again in the fifth instar. 2 times space is required to increase than the previous instar. In a standard size rearing tray, 300 larvae of fifth instar silkworms can be reared conveniently. This is an important aspect which needs maximum care. Overcrowded bed does not permit free and complete growth of the silkworm. It is very important for the various and full growth of silkworm. As the silkworms grow in size and weight, the bed density increases leading to crowding. Therefore, the population density in a rearing bed should be regulated to ideal condition. In the rearing, most of the failures are because of the improper spacing in the bed. As the age of the silkworm increases, the length and breadth also increases. Chalky rearing. Overcrowding of silkworms means insufficient space for the movement and free feeding of the silkworm. Crowded conditions favors the increases gases and fermentation of fecal matter. Fermentation process particularly happens during early stages when temperature and humidity are high. In this condition, silkworms do not feed freely. This results in unequal and unhealthy growth of larvae. The silkworms become weak and easily susceptible to various diseases, the commercial character are also severely affected. This able is indicates the need to expand and rearing bed from time to time, thereby orderly growth of silkworm can be expected. Rearing schedule. Sparse spacing of silkworm is not desirable as it leads to wastage of mulberry leaf. In a normal condition, the space is double or triple from first instar to third instar. On the whole, the space has to be increased by 80 to 100 times from brushing to ripening of silkworm spinning. Time and frequency of spacing. Spacing should go simultaneously with continuous development of silkworm. Therefore, silkworms are spaced at each feeding. The development of silkworm is most rapid in first stage. Thus, spacing is done frequently and it is always advantageous to combine spacing with cleaning. This saves labor also. In further instar, spacing is combined with cleaning. When the humidity and temperature are higher than optimum, then the silkworms are spaced. The rearing trays are kept in alternate cells for free circulation of air. Method of spacing. The spacing can be conducted separately or in combination with cleaning. Among these two are the latest method is convenient and satisfactory. It helps in less handling and less disturbance of silkworm. Late age silkworm rearing. Bed cleaning. It is a process to remove waste and harmful material found in the rearing bed. Bed cleaning is done daily during 4th and 5th instar. In branch feeding, shoot feeding and individual leaf feeding, they are cut into small pieces before feeding. Generally, bed cleaning is preferably after first feeding. The net size of 20 mm square is spread prior to feeding. The bed cleaning is done before the second feed, where the silkworms along with net and leaves are transferred into a fresh tray. The fecal matters and remnant of mulberry leaves are put into manure pit. While cleaning, attention should be paid to keep the rearing room, floor and premises clean and tidy. Spacing. Spacing of silkworms in the rearing bed play a vital role for the success of silkworm crop and improvement of cocoon quality. Besides all precautions taken while feeding of the worms by adequate leaves, crowded condition leads to undernourishment and uneven development of the silkworms. Further, it favors the incidence of diseases and yield of inferior quality of cocoons. Overspacing leads to leaf wastage and higher the leaf cocoon ratio. Therefore, optimum spacing based on the growth of different instar is necessary to get good crop. Spacing should be increased simultaneously with the growth of the larvae. It is better to space the worms while bed cleaning. The latest silkworms are spaced every day.